Lyle's
got a cast around his
cankles.
And I'll bet if he had the moment back, he'd jump from a different angle.
World famous Kyle, go to sleep.
Little Drip.
At least for little Drip. A little while.
Smeardrick Drindrin.
That's Smeardrick Drindrin.
Attorney at Slaw.
Okay, all right. Let's think about this. Let's knock this one out the park.
I want to talk about how we had just come home from a really long drive, and all I remember of this session is eating a Nashville hot chicken sandwich and sleeping on the couch for like 10 hours.
Oh, yeah.
And then I went, fill me up! And that's all I contributed to the song.
And a brilliant contribution it was.
Thank you.
Oh, fill me up.
It's a little toony, but that's what the band would want.
And we set out to sound like the band for this one.
Nice.
If it has strings or reeds, McKendrick is probably really good at it.
This is McKendrick's lap steel. It's the something bird frying pan.
It's a lap steel, right?
We should give him a call and ask him about it.
Let's ask him.
Is he gonna pick up?
I know he's awake, that dirty little. Well, that was going to be your moment, McKendrick. Anyway, Lars played some really cool country licks on this song, and it's one of my favorite parts of the record. So, Tommy, let's hear a couple of those. Lars, talk to me.
Just beautiful.
As I turn each day a little shade older.
George Harrison moment.
That Wurlitzer you were hearing was played by our dear friend Spencer Thomas.
Spanky.
And Reagan's roommate, by the way. A Mississippi boy, just like our twins.
Me too.
Wow. A lot of Mississippi.
Yeah. You can hear it in the song.
That's a bet.
What's this song about, Taylor?
I thought this song was about friends of mine struggling with their identity.
He walks a mile in a blouse with purple sequins. And it's true, as his eyes are black and blue, but no one believes him.
It's about friends, and it's also about an imaginary sad sack. But I think, as corny as it is, it's about me feeling like a sad sack sometimes.
Everybody feels like a sad sack sometimes.
I know it. I know it to be true.
If every band-aid tells a story, and all the hurt.
My Division II fifth grade peewee football coach said that pain is just weakness leaving the body. And for better or worse, that really stuck with me.
To me, this song is about taking those moments where you feel like a sad sack and rising above them and learning from them, and they are what make you, you.
Yeah, definitely. And also, like, everyone giving you advice when you're looking for it and when you're not looking for it about how to feel better.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's kind of funny.
Right. at the end of the day, the song is a little silly.
Yeah, it's like a little silly. And sometimes it's kind of funny when someone's like, here's how you feel better.
Right.
But then when we get to sing this song live, it's fun. And I do feel better.
It's everybody's favorite.
Let's go.
Because Kyle's world's a dog pile.
When we first started picturing the first record as a record, we threw around the name Dogpile a lot, and it ended up in the photo with us in a big dog pile, and we brought it back around in the lyrics of this song.
Right. That record ended up being self-titled, but I always wanted to use Dogpile in a lyric.
Yeah, there's something cool about the word.
And Kyle's world in the song, and I think everyone's world sometimes ends up in a dog pile.
Yeah, and you're on the bottom.
Exactly.
To end Perfect Heaven and bring the dog pile back around, it's like you're on the top of the dog pile this time. It's triumphant. The song is triumphant to me.
Okay, Benny.
So let's listen to it. Let's listen to World Famous Kyle, the last song on Perfect Heaven, our second record as a band.
Thank you all so much for listening.
And let's fucking go. Heffner to the moon.
Heffner to the moon. We'll see you on the next one.